Welcome back, Spartans. In the late hours of July 6th, Catalog completed its query and provided the biggest information drop to date, both in terms of reveals and in terms of word count. So, let's not waste any time.
Query complete. Connected.
Now, there's a lot going on at the start here, so let's break it down piece by piece. This starts with Catalog completing its query. Now, I'm convinced there's an error here because Catalog says quer, which, as far as I can tell, means why. Why complete? Makes no sense, so it's probably meant to be query. After that, we get our usual mystery message. This one's saying all law follows the mantle, and some Latin that translates as justice follows the law. In short, justice follows the mantle, or the mantle is justice.
Branch, warning. System diagnostics / security / log / apparitor. Alert. Critical reconciliation errors detected in security logs. Spurious data / no ref.
In or dine.
Alert. Critical failure. Unable to access domain interlink. Local loop cache approved by conditor. Alert. Fleet command alert. Containment failure at Maginot line. Alert. Connection loss to Ecumen control. Alert. Connection loss to Ecumen oversight. Alert. Connection loss to quadrant oversight. Alert. Star Road, Loci, activity flux reported near Erigress hours ago. Alert. Parasite, Classes, detected in Adolm airspace Erigress hours ago. Estimate position overrun in 2 hours. Alert. Local fleet assets expanded. Sentinel, Fundibulari, engaging local craft en route to Erdetairin. Alert. Parasite, Classes, holding position. Threat dynamic analysis ongoing. Alert. Override authority granted by Conditor for Equus. And Oxila, Suscipio. Alert. Connection loss to sector oversight. Alert. Slipstream space activity.
So this bit is pretty interesting, as it seems to follow the final moments of the Forerunner Flood War. It also seems to reveal the name of our mysterious catalog, X.E8. I can't say for sure if XE8 is the actual name or designation of our particular catalog unit, but it seems to be the most logical conclusion. After some warnings, we get a log of recorded events in order according to catalog from the Adolm terminal. We start with a note of the domain being inaccessible, which it practically was in the final days of the war, followed by the lost connection to the Forerunner Ecumen. Next up are notes about the increased Star Road activity, then an alert to flood activity in Adolm airspace. Now this is really interesting, since, about a day before the array was fired, the librarian saw star roads in the Sol system, near Mars, but never going any further. This is also reflected with the Flood fleet halting its advance on Earth, according to the Adolm terminal logs.
Alert! Adolm control recovered from archive. Integrity check failed. Alert! Intrusion detected in site fractal. Builder security alerted. Alert! Physical intrusion detected in archival data center. Builder security alerted. Alert! Builder security vigilius cannot be contacted. Priority site emergency containment protocols require approval by builder authorities. Alert! Unauthorized constructs detected in archival data center. Cyber intrusion response logs 9204. Unauthorized constructs unraveled. Construct spoor forwarded to builder security. Alert! Physical intrusion detected in relay center row. Builder security alerted. Alert! Builder security vigilius cannot be contacted. Emergency containment protocols approved by facility AI and Bugatti. Relay Center Row, self-destruct successful. Relay Center Row offline. Alert, Builder Security has failed to refresh for regress. Warning, rogue processes detected in tertiary storage. Trapdoor.4096/non-authorized. Warning, exemption error. Log errors, fieri non potest.
This next part is about a break-in at Site Fractal, which, if you remember, we heard about during some early conversations with Catalog. See earlier videos for details. After that, we see an alert that says several AI have tried to access the Adolm terminal but were all unraveled, likely meaning they were destroyed. I do have to wonder if these were human AI or perhaps corrupted Forerunner AI or something else entirely. It's hard to say since we don't know when Site Fractal was broken into. It could be that the Covenant were trying to break in during their time on Mars during the invasion of Earth.
Break.
Warning. System diagnostics / maintenance / log / apparitor. Alert. 782 priority maintenance requests awaiting action. Alert! Critical plasma containment failure in secondary storage imminent. Alert! Emergency slipstream space transport conduits offline. Alert! Sentinel constructor cradles inaccessible. Alert! Sentinel control not responding. Alert! Field integrity failure in sublevel 9. Vix Luminae structural failures reported. Warning, plasma containment failure in tertiary storage site Alpha. Data loss estimated at 3.2 yottabytes. Warning, plasma containment failure in tertiary storage site Beta. Data loss estimated at 0.6 yottabytes. Warning, 14,819 overdue maintenance requests awaiting action.
So, next, it seems the catalog tries to interrupt the data feed, but to no avail. Now, one line above all stands out to me, this being the mention of emergency slipspace transport conduits. So, this could mean a lot of things. Does this mean that Mars, like, the whole planet is capable of a slipspace jump? Could this mean that the Atom terminal is actually located on one of Mars' moons? It's certainly easier to transport an asteroid than a planet. Or is the Atom terminal capable of independent slipspace travel, perhaps being a buried ship of sorts? And perhaps the biggest question, is this slipspace conduit the means by which the Gravemind got to the Ark? For context, an older post by Catalog revealed that, on November 18th, a slipspace disturbance was detected near Mars, referencing High Charity making a jump toward the Ark. However, it's a bit of a mystery as to what on Mars allowed it to do this. Yes, High Charity does have its own slipspace drives, but they are nowhere near as powerful. The popular theory is that there was a portal on Mars, and maybe we just found it. We end this segment with several alerts about plasma containment failure in data storage sites resulting in yottabytes of data loss. For context, a single yottabyte is 1 trillion terabytes. Yeah, lots of data loss. Oh, and 14,819 overdue maintenance requests. Seems that the Atom terminal monitor is about as dutiful as 2401 penitent tangent. Or offline. Or destroyed.
System analysis error. Error. Facility AI not responding. Redirect failure.
Vocatio, 4096. Authority juridical.
Error.
Vocatio, 4096. Authority juridical. 4096, you are summoned for diagnostic review.
Facility AI not responding.
4096, your non-compliance has been noted. Explicatio.
Our introduction of sorts ends with Catalog trying to contact the monitor of the Atom site, its number being 4096. So, now that that's done, let's move on to the questions. Any information on the whereabouts of the UNSC Rubicon?
Query response. Human naval and frumentary records list Speculatoria Navigia Rubicon as Nau Fragum, July 2nd, 2557.
It seems someone inquired about the UNSC Rubicon. For those who don't know, this was an Oni vessel sent to investigate a mysterious signal that originated from the remains of the Ark. The Rubicon was surprised to find that the source was a damaged armature of a monitor 343 Guilty Spark. Thing was, the personality that awoke on board the Rubicon wasn't Spark, but Chakas, an ancient human who was composed and later became Guilty Spark. This encounter was detailed in the book Halo Primordium, Chakas acting as the in-universe source for that book. It seems Oni has declared the ship missing, if not destroyed, as of July 2nd, 2557. The word naufragum means shipwreck, so it's unclear if this is an imperfect translation or if Oni knows, for a fact, that the Rubicon was shipwrecked. What were the remains of Spartan Davis transformed into on the Forerunner moon orbiting Dreitheus V?
Query response. Analysis of human Operation Hydra Security Force combat data, REF, Spartan Assault. Indicate application of unknown sublimation device. Searching. Updating coordinates from Atom Control. Searching. Location coincide with OR-3-212E. Priority minor facilities noted. No records of sublimation mechanism at site. Warning. Time since last successful synchronization. 876,621,429 plus minus 512 hours.
This is in reference to Spartan Assault. At the end of the game, Spartan Davis was caught in a Forerunner device meant to build and destroy planets. I don't know what this person really expected to learn. The device in question only built and destroyed planets. It was trying to make a planet out of Davis. Still, we do learn the Forerunner designation for Dreitheus V, and it is confirmed to be a minor facility. What's weird is that Catalog says there's no record of the Forerunner Death Star at the site. Could this simply be a reference to its destruction, or could it mean that the device was never meant to be there? So many mysteries. Query, what is the status of the Ur-Didact?
Searching. Result. Case record sealed on authority of Master Juridical. Revoked Ecumen Control. Authorization requested. July 22nd, 2557. Bears sigil. Shadow of Sundered Star. Revoked Ecumen Control. Authorization requested. July 23rd, 2557. Bears sigil. Shadow of Sundered Star. Revoked Ecumen Control. Authorization requested. July 24th, 2557. Bears sigil. Shadow of Sundered Star. Unauthorized slipstream space. Portal activity in Air de Tyrene airspace. July 25th, 2557. Bears sigil. Shadow of sundered star. Ekumene control authorization requested. March 3rd, 2558. Bears sigil. Didact. Identity contested. Unauthorized communication channel noted.
Vocatio. 4096. Authority juridical. 4096. You will provide all communication records related to these matters. 4096. You will explain non-disclosure of Ekumene control authorization requests. Expectatio.
Adam control indicates continued control devolution of warrior servant Imperium.
Scrutor control devolution. Warrior servant dictata. Scrutor control devolution. Juridical dictata.
System slash analysis slash apparitor. Searching.
Seriatim.
So again, we see this revoked request for Ekumene control, but it seems that the Didact kept trying every 24 hours. After that, we see a note of a subspace portal opening over Earth, Air de Tyrene, this referencing the portal open beneath the Composer. Perhaps the most exciting part is that the terminal notes a request for Ekumene control on March 3rd, 2558. Now, this isn't revealed until later, but on July 6th for us, the date for catalog was March 3rd, 2558. What's strange is that, until now, the Terminal has referenced the Ur-Didact by his true name, Shadow of Sundered Star. In the March 3rd request, it calls the requester Didact. Is this simply because the request was so recent? Could it be Julim Dama calling out using the Didact's sigil? He did something like this at the end of Spartan Ops when he sent Requiem into its sun. Or perhaps, could this be the Iso Didact or one of his descendants? Again, lots of possibilities. We end with Catalog trying to talk with the monitor of the Adam site, asking it to explain these requests. When 4096 fails to respond, Catalog starts searching to find out who or what is in control of the Forerunner Ekumene, or rather, what rate should be at the top. Devolution means to hand control of a government to a lower or lesser power. We end with Catalog saying, Seriatim, meaning going over something point by point, likely the laws regarding control of the Ekumene. Query, what criteria allows certain humans to be designated as reclaimers, while others are not, as evident by failed Covenant attempts to access Requiem systems via kidnapped humans?
Query, answer. Reclaimer is not a legitimate client species status. Adam control refers to new consul emergency directives, leges posteriores, priores, contrarias, abrogant, given on authority of librarian and didact. Master juridical concurrence not recorded, ius nullum. Status confirmed by analysis of Gaia Symphonia. Alert. Substantial alteration of canonical implementation of human supplicium detected in Symphonia scope.
Ooh, a fun one. So, in one of the final episodes of Spartan Ops, it was revealed that not all humans are designated as reclaimers. This has been somewhat bothersome for many fans. It seems now that the presence of a Gaia is what denotes the reclaimer status. However, it seems that not all humans have Gaia. Very interesting. We end with an alert about substantial alteration of canonical implementation of human supplicium. Supplicium means execution or punishment. Could this be a reference to the severe human casualties of the Human Covenant War or the attack on New Phoenix or something else? Time will tell. Query, how does the Type 33 Needler fire and lock onto its targets in air?
Query, answer. Analysis of human material exploitation reports, reference REAP-X, is inconclusive. Reports reference collaborative research with Nartocognatus, OPFEX, from Factional, Fabrique, reference Colar Manufactorum, that are located in inaccessible Frumentari cores. Crystallographic analysis of Suban, dataset is outside Catalog's purview.
So it seems that the Needler's firing mechanism remains out of our reach for now. In-universe, it's a mystery, but it seems that Oni, notably the REAP-X division, is working with Sangheili workers from the Kolar Manufactorum to understand the Needler's inner workings. What needs to be in place to render the Composer capable of operating successfully and reverse constructing biological matter out of digital construct?
Query, answer. Alert. Essence sheathing is expressly prohibited. Ref, Ingenia, no records of successful essence sheathing in local cache. Technical analysis of sublimation. Design implementations are outside catalog's purview.
Basically, catalog doesn't know how the composer could be used to return digitized beings to organic forms. Makes sense, since no Forerunner ever discovered how to do it. What was the sentient race, or races, responsible for the vessel that crash-landed on Installation 04, thousands of years before the UNSC and Covenant arrived in 2552 AD?
Query, answer. Analysis of surface detail. Data recovered at Alpha Site. Terminal is inconclusive. Hull pattern is analogous to seven client species designs in forensic database. Scan of vessel remains and or propulsion signature data requires further evaluation.
Once again, Catalog dodges the question about the species that crash-landed on Installation 04's surface so many thousands of years ago. It is interesting, though, that it notes that the ship design matches seven known species designs. Another seven reference, too. Plus, the mysterious ship is purple with green lights, similar to Covenant tech, particularly the ancient ships shown on the cover of Halo Broken Circle.
Query, answer. Hue of hull plating is not diagnostic.
What can you tell us about the operational status of the Covenant assault carrier, Shadow of Intent, as of March 2558?
Query, answer. Human naval and frumentary records indicate Covenant destroyer, Shadow of Intent as priority intelligence target. Records indicate repair and refit of vessel at mobile shipyard in records inaccessible. System, December 30th, 2552. Deployed to Air de Tayrin, February 29th through March 3rd, 2553, for diplomatic mission. No records of vessel and associated support vessels from March 6, 2553, through August 24, 2553. Through Matari signal analysis, infers deployment to Providence's to search and assess, after return of Covenant, long-range exploratory fleets. Deployed in internecine conflicts in CE-80-9012, REF, URS, system and topologically proximate, transit points from May 24, 2553, through April 15, 2554. Rendered combat ineffective during fleet action against Covenant faction forces. Ref. Jewel Umdama. In. Records inaccessible. System. On. April 22nd, 2554. No records of vessel from April 22nd, 2554 through November 6th, 2556. Human naval. Chatter. Reference vessel several times in Onion. Encrypted communications not accessible to full frumentary analysis. Inferred activity against Service Federal. Fleet elements in Lacto Cognatus Core Sphere. Vessel appeared with unidentified logistical support craft November 6, 2556 in URS system to pacify faction forces. Vessel left URS system February 2, 2557 on diplomatic mission to Covenant Sphere. Participated in Ejercitatio with human naval elements May 6, 2557 through June 1, 2557 against in mixed zone of control, REF, joint operation zone. Frumentary threat dynamic analysis noted significant improvement in the vessel dynamic capabilities and alterations to nanolaminate hull plating. Analysis of detritus collected after Ejercitatio purged from Frumentary low echelon secure network and forwarded to priority cores. Vessel dispatched with support fleet June 1, 2557 through March 3, 2558 to protect Magno Cognatus core sphere. Recent Frumentary records naufragum of three Speculatoria Navigia tasked to monitor vessel's fleet activities. Losses not reported to human naval authorities.
Now this was one of my favorite ones to read. We finally get an update about Urtas Vadum, or at least his ship, the Shadow of Intent. So we start with a note that the ship was undergoing refit and repair as of December 30th, 2552. Since the release of Glasslands, there has been a slight discrepancy about the timeline of events between the Arbiter returning to Earth from the Ark and when he and Urtas returned to San Helios. In Glasslands, the Arbiter had returned to San Helios by January 2553, and yet, at the end of Halo 3, which takes place in March of 2553, Urtas says he wants to...
I would like to see a woman, to know that it is safe.
Fear not, for we have made it safe.
By your word, Arbiter.
Take us home.
Implying that he had not returned. It's not a real, directly stated discrepancy, but certainly felt out of place to a number of fans. So it seems that, at least of December 30th, 2552, the Shadow of Intent was undergoing repairs, which may explain Urtas' line at the end of Halo 3. Moving forward, we see that the ship was present on Earth between February 29th through March 3rd... Wait... February 29th? 2553 isn't a leap year? That's kind of weird. Anyway, so this reflects again what we see in Glasslands. Then, between March 3rd and August 24th, 2553, the Shadow was sent to recover long-range exploration fleets. Did anyone just imagine a Covenant version of Star Trek? Between May 24th, 2553, and April 15th, 2554, the Shadow engaged in devastating battles near Sanghelios and the surrounding space, likely a reference to the Sangheili Civil War that we saw started during the Kilo 5 trilogy. Just 8 days later, the Shadow was severely damaged in an unnamed system by a Covenant faction led by Jewel Umdama. It's nice to know that Umdama was operating as early as 2554. After that, there is no direct record of the Shadow of Intent's activities between April 22nd, 2554, and November 6th, 2556. And note, a reference to Halo 4's release date there. During this period, there is inferred action against Jiro Hanai forces within Sangheili space, based on human naval chatter. Seems to be a nice reference to the full-on war between these two species, first mentioned in The Return. On November 6th, the Shadow is again recorded in action near Sanghelios, with an unidentified support craft. I can't help but wonder if this might be a reference to the Lich, since the Lich is the only Covenant ship slash aircraft designated as Type 56, the 56 of course referencing the year it was recorded. It could also be just about anything, so yeah. Moving forward, the Shadow left Sanghelios on February 2nd, 2557, for a diplomatic mission with what is referred to as the Covenant Sphere. As we saw at the start of Halo Escalation, the purpose of the meeting on Aelin was to forge a peace between the Jiro Hanai and the Sangheili. Could Shadow's diplomatic mission have been an early attempt or even the early steps of this attempted peace? Between May 6th and June 1st of 2557, the Shadow engaged pirates with UNSC forces in a joint occupation zone. It's interesting to think that only 4.5 years after the end of the Human Covenant War, that there are joint occupation zones. Anyway, during these engagements, it was noted that the Shadow had improved its weapons and hull plating. Since then, the Shadow of Intent has, along with a support fleet, been on continuous deployment to protect Sanghelios and her colonies. Recently, in-universe, 3 Oni Prowlers sent to monitor the Shadow had been destroyed, but their destruction has remained unreported to the UNSC. Query, what is the status of Spartan 3 Gamma Company?
Query, answer. Unit disbanded. Surviving members integrated into human, exorati, or returned to non-combatant status.
Yes! I've been waiting to know something, anything! About Spartan 3 Gamma Company. So, while I would have liked to know more, this tidbit is definitely satisfactory. It seems that Gamma Company, like the other Spartan 3s, were allowed to join the Spartan 4 program, or were designated to non-combatant status. Now, if I'm interpreting this right, they were released from the Spartan program and returned to civilian life. What is the status of the Huraga codenamed Virgil?
Query, answer. Records currently stored in inaccessible cores.
Damn you, catalog! Not really, but, you know. What is the current status of the Born Stellar Didact?
Query, answer. Record sealed pending juridical review of new council activities.
See previous reply. Query, are there any independent factions of Ungoy following the fall of the Covenant that haven't been absorbed into larger organizations?
Query, answer. Frumentari records speculate that several vessels and colony vessels are now under the control of Monachus Fagus faction forces. No significant population of unaffiliated Monachus Fagus are known to exist in human core sphere.
Basically, Oni thinks there may be independent factions of Ungoy around, but none have been directly observed. Query, are Lidus and the Brute Chieftain in Halo Wars the same?
Query, answer. Records provided to human naval authorities by Allied Macto Cognatus indicate that Master Pat Commander Lidus did not leave CE-75-2113 Ref Oth Sonin system until 2546.
To me, this was an obvious answer, but we do learn the Forerunner designation for Doisiak, or rather its system, so that's kind of cool. Catalog. Can the augmentation process that made Sergeant Major Avery Jr. Johnson immune to flood infection be replicated?
Query, answer. No known biological scaffolding augmentation impedes efficacy of parasite conversion process.
So, this is an interesting one. The debate over Sergeant Johnson's immunity to the flood has been a long-standing one, with both sides firmly holding to their beliefs. Bungie has, in the past, stated that Sergeant Johnson is not immune to the flood, but no official source has backed this up. Even the reissues of First Strike, the book that brought this plot point up, didn't change it. Could Catalog be confirming that Johnson is not immune to the Flood, or stating that it simply has no way of knowing if someone can become immune to the Flood? Either really makes sense, considering Johnson's supposed immunity was never reported to the UNSC, and it was an accident. If other Spartan ones are immune is entirely unknown. What is the status of the Life Shaper, Chantigreen?
Query, answer. No cases pending against Lifeworker Chantigreen. Multiple reconciliation errors noted in local cache. Adam Control indicates prenomino to Life Shaper status. Final legal status pending review. Quo waranto.
Scrutor, Control, Devolution. Lifeworker Dictata. Priority juridical review. Continuity of government.
Contacting domain. Failure. Regress. Alert. Critical reconciliation error. Contacting domain. Failure. Regress. Alert. Critical reconciliation error.
So, Catalog states that Chantigreen's promotion to Life Shaper, a title given to her by the librarian at the end of Silentium, is officially recorded by the Adam Terminal, but the legal status of this title has not undergone proper review. With this, Catalog begins a search under Lifeworker Dictata, trying to see if the Lifeworker rate should now be the highest in the Ecumen, and opens a review into the continuity of the Forerunner government. Just to note, Lifeworkers are a higher rate, above both Juridicals and Warrior Servants. What is the status of Installation 07's quarantine?
Query, answer. Records provided to human naval authorities by Allied Macto Cognatus indicate implementation of adequate containment and sterilization protocols within infected zone. Adam Control unable to contact installation monitor for regress cycles, requesting outside status from Ecumen Control.
So, this was in reply to a question about Installation 07, but it sounds more like Catalog is talking about Installation 05. I think it's weird to think that the Sangheili had discovered Installation 07, but anything is possible. Humanity literally stumbled upon Installation 03. No secret Forerunner star charts or following a slipspace wake a la Halo 2. Just, boom, Halo. Assuming this is about Installation 07, it seems that Sangheili forces have cauterized the surface of the ring, meaning that the Flood that had been trapped there since the time of the Forerunner Flood War were destroyed. Who built the various ancient ruins on Installation 05?
Query, answer. Records of surface fittings by Delta Site sealed by authority of Ecumen Control.
Again, curses! This is something that we really need to know. Well, not need, but certainly desperately want. And this is why I'm not looking forward to the Halo 2 terminals as much as I should be. It's all about the Arbiter, but there's so much more to explore. Anyway, I'm getting off topic. Do you, Catalog, have access to information in regards to the events that transpired post-Human Covenant War on Kolo?
Query, answer. Current date is 3rd March, 2558.
This is something we've been waiting for, a time frame for Catalog's posts. As of July 6, 2014, the date for Catalog was March 3rd, 2558. This is one day before the peace talks on Aelin. Could Cortana, Spartan John 117's AI companion, have survived after the events that occurred on Requiem in 2557, or even after the planet was destroyed?
Query, answer. Unauthorized constructs are prohibited from accessing any Forerunner systems. Further analysis of Hybrid, Template, Ancilla. Ref CTN 0452-9. Capabilities are outside Catalog's purview.
So, Catalog has no way of knowing if Cortana could have survived the events of Halo 4. I do find it interesting that Catalog refers to Cortana as a hybrid. Now, this could be a reference to her unique creation, or something more. Cortana's creation was part of the Librarian's plan, after all, even referred to as an evolved Ancilla.
Is this the secret you've kept from me? This evolved Ancilla.
Catalog, are there any records pertaining to the 6 Huragok taken from the Meddler flagship Ascendant Justice, or the Huragok discovered near the Ark portal? Frumentari Command's records seem sketchy in this regard, both in numbers and dates.
Query, answer. Utilization of Builder or Lifeworker, Factitius Indoles, is prohibited. Ref. Amicus Primori Generis. Records of Factitius Indoles. Locations and status currently stored in inaccessible Frumentari cores.
So Catalog currently does not have access to the location of captured Huragok, which is kind of disappointing. One of the major plot holes since Glasslands has been the status of previously captured Huragok, both those captured at the end of First Strike, and Virgil in Halo 3 ODST. We also have this bit of Latin, Amicius Primero Generis, which roughly means a friend to mankind, though it's preceded with a statement prohibiting the use of Huragok. Maybe just saying that only humans are meant to use them? What is the status of the Halo arrays?
Query, answer. Requesting site status from Ekumene Control.
Query, is there any information on the potential identity of those whom the Ur-Didact was addressing after the events of the Requiem event?
Query, answer. Selected quote is part of evidential proceedings recorded in local cache prior to loss of domain contact.
Now, this one has sent the community ablaze with debate. Many lore buffs have been saying, and this includes myself, that the Didact speech at the end of Halo 4 had to have taken place after the events of Halo 4. While much of the Didact speech could be placed just about any time before the activation of the Halo Array, there is one line that ruled out for many of us this possibility.
We squander eons in the darkness, while they seize our triumphs for their own.
This line should affirm, beyond a shadow of a doubt, that the speech took place after Halo 4. Still, according to Catalog, this is not the case, and people have been scrambling to discover when the speech took place. A later post by Catalog gave hope that we might discover the truth about this speech in the near future.
Query, answer. Searching. Statement was not in error. However, Catalog does note difficulty in interpreting Shadow of Sundered Stars commentary, currently under review due to multiple sources of authority.
The weekend is here, so hopefully we won't have to wait long. Query, could the unidentified alien vessel which crashed on Installation 04 have released dormant microbial life?
Query, answer. Parasite containment and control protocols do not preclude incidental contamination.
Query, how does the entity known as the United Nations, which is still seemingly existent according to certain records, relate to the Unified Earth Government? What is the UN's official function in the 26th century?
Query, answer. Human records indicate that the Assembly, REF, United Nations, is a vestigial organization responsible for adjudication of administrative tasks between territorial sectors of Erde Tyrene.
So it seems that the UN is still around, but considered a vestigial organization. A good comparison might be townships in the United States, once necessary for governing small local areas, but now, well, vestigial. Useless. Query, as of 2558, has the UNSC yet relinquished its emergency powers to the civilian government?
Query, answer. Human records indicate transition to non-combative administration control, REF, UEG, January 8th, 2553. No notable adjustments in military, bureaucratic, tactical, behavior, and scope of authority.
So, as noted in Glasslands, the UNSC did hand over its emergency powers to the UEG in January of 2553, though we now have a definitive date. Interesting, though, is that the UNSC continues to act in the same capacity as it did during the war. Now, given 27 years of war and control, it makes sense that the UNSC would continue to act in a similar capacity for some time, even if they technically don't have the authority. Query, what is the ideal human lifespan in the 26th century? That is, provided steady access to medical treatments and discounting the obvious distortion of statistics caused by the death of the war.
Query, answer. Significant distortion of human population structure cannot be discounted at present. Integration of new life augmentation technologies further distort analysis required to generate life table. Request for detailed analysis of human biological robustness forwarded to index technician.
So, basically, Catalog cannot give a proper answer given the massive casualties of the Human Covenant War. Query, how does the anarchic rank structure of the UNSC military branch known as Spartan work in relation to the UNSC's other military branches? What is the practical significance of the SR rank structure? Who comprises the functional leadership of the branch and who comprises the Spartan branch in HICOM and or the UNSC Security Council? Does the Spartan branch answer to UNICOM or NAVCOM?
System analysis error. Multiple queries detected in string.
Yeah, we've seen this before. One question per query. Query, which one does the UNSC Air Force fall under, UNICOM or NAVCOM?
Query, answer. Human aerospace, assets allocated to Air Force control, fall under Terrestrial Combatant Command, REF, UNICOM.
Query, what is the technological basis of the FTL communication systems used by the present-day UNSC, pre- and post-Trevelyan Forerunner discoveries? Slipspace quantum entanglement, as with the Forerunners, or some other, perhaps more esoteric technology?
Query, answer. A technical architectural briefing of client species is currently under construction by Scriba.
Scriba is Latin for scriptor, possibly meaning that someone at 343 is working on an explanation for human FTL communications. Query, does the de facto location of the star system known as Epsilon Indy coincide with the 21st century human observation of said system? I ask this because there is a discrepancy between the apparent distance to said system, Harvest being humanity's most distant colony, and early observational evidence of the system being only 11 light-years from Earth, and thus only half a light-year further than one of the closest colonies, Reach.
Query, answer. Slipstream space. Transit records record liminal, sphere, colony, ref, harvest, as furthest official human colony. Slipstream space topology is not consistent with Euclidean distance, but significant discrepancy is noted. Updating coordinates from Adam Control. Searching. Location coincident with CE-309-8D, ref, harvest. Location coincident with UC-901-9081, ref, Epsilon Indy. CE-309-8D, conservation sphere, way station, facility, and quadrinary LF.XX.3273, research and containment facility present. Multiple quies est solum, eas est usque, ad coelum. Violations inferred. Filing cases. Request juridical advocates ad litem for summary judgment. UC-901-9081, system surveyed by Pioneer Group. No further records found in local cache. Discrepancy is a result of historical propaganda considerations during the initial sphere expansion, orbiter dictum.
This is another long-standing discrepancy within the Halo universe. Harvest has always been said to be one of the furthest colonies from Earth, and yet it is located in the Epsilon Indy system. For reference, Epsilon Indy is 12 light-years from Earth, while Epsilon Eridani, where Reach is located, is 10.5 light-years. Another outer colony, Madrigal, is located in the 23 Libre system, which is 84 light-years from Earth. So, yeah, kind of a big issue. Now, according to Catalog, despite being 12 light-years from Earth, Harvest is the furthest human colony in terms of slipspace travel. Still, it does note the discrepancy and searches for an explanation. During the search, we get two results, one being the Forerunner designation for Harvest and the other for the Epsilon Indy system. Now, what's weird is that, given instances of the Forerunner designation system, we have two Epsilon Indy systems. Could this mean that Harvest is not part of the Epsilon Indy system we know? It is noted that Harvest was, during the time of the Forerunners, a conservation sphere way station, or a way station for a shield world. What sort of way station is unknown, but it is also noted that Harvest was designated as a quaternary flood research and containment facility. Now, whether it was ever used is still unknown, but it sure explains why the Sangheili Zealot in Halo Wars was so worried about the presence of the Flood.
The Hierarchs grow impatient. We can delay no longer.
What if the infection defiles the relic?
I care not for your little life. Open the relic.
The next line sees the return of the Latin line, quies est solum, eas est usque ad coelum. To refresh, this is a legal term meaning that when one owns a plot of land, they own the sky above and the ground below. It's still unclear if this is a reference to the uncovering of Forerunner relics or the glassing of the planet, but I would probably guess the latter. Finally, Catalog files cases regarding the violations and notes that the discrepancy that has plagued Halo for some time is the result of historical propaganda during the time Harvest was originally colonized. So at the time of its colonization, Harvest was in fact the furthest colony from Earth, but that is no longer the case. It seems like a nice compromise between conflicting sources, without completely overwriting existing canon. Query, what is the nature and extent of Forerunner construction on Adam as of 2558? Are elements of the UNSC aware of said artifacts?
Query, answer. Cyber intrusion of human fermentary cores will determine extent of trespass.
Query, what is the nature of the transference of a Forerunner's or Ancilla's consciousness into the domain upon death? Is it enabled by technologies, e.g. Forerunner armor, durances, or does it happen to all Forerunners by virtue of an inherent link with the domain? How does the durance stored essence relate to this, i.e. does the durance enable the mind state's connection to the domain, or are there essences in the domain and the one in the durance is separate?
Query, answer. Information on specifics of domain interlink is purview of Harspus.
Why was the explorer ship Audacity's voyage to Pathkathona considered so incredibly reconciliation costly when said voyage involved far less mass transit over a shorter distance than the construction of both Ark installations, as well as the transport of multiple resource planetoids to the Arks?
Query, answer. Reconciliation costs scale non-linearly with discrepancy in information transfer between locations and brain tension. Vessel mass is primarily a consideration with slipstream space, transit energy requirements, and buffer generation.
A recent discrepancy has been why the journey to the Large Magellanic Cloud, Pathkathona to the Forerunners, was such a costly trip in terms of reconciliation, despite the fact that the distance to the Lesser Ark, and presumably the Greater Ark, are far greater distances. The Large Magellanic Cloud is about 163,000 light-years away, while the lesser arc is 262,144 light-years away. According to Catalog, reconciliation costs are not consistent, and while the size has a major effect on reconciliation, the cost is also determined by information transfer and brain tension. Now, brain refers to a number of theoretical objects, this one being part of theoretical physics. These brains contain the various dimensions. Slipspace travel allows transit to higher brains and puts stress on these dimensional planes. Query, what is the status of the juridical network? Still having issues with that logic plague code?
Query, answer. Internal documentation of juridical activities is not subject to external review.
Query, there is a record, reference, Ghost of Onyx, of the Covenant conducting excavations at Mount Erebus and in the Yucatan Peninsula during their invasion of Earth. Do you have information on possible Forerunner artifacts in said locations?
Searching. System analysis error. Alert. Local cache discrepancies in Erdotyrene facility listing exceed expected bounds. Consult portal library link.
Ah, Ghosts of Onyx, a great read. In the book, besides the portal at Voy, there are references to other Covenant dig sites as mentioned above. Sadly, it seems Catalog cannot tell us what the Covenant we're looking for. Query, what was the rank of Spartan Sarah Palmer before her enlistment with the Spartan branch? One record, reference Halo Waypoint Halo 4 Game Guide, states that she was a lieutenant, while another, reference Halo Initiation, claims that she was a Lance Corporal and then a Corporal at the time of her becoming a Spartan.
Query, answer. Human records indicate that Explorator Palmer was rated E-4 and placed for acceleration consideration for E-5 at time of transfer.
Here we go again with Palmer's rank. Now, according to the Halo 4 Interactive Guide, Palmer was a lieutenant before joining the Spartans and a notable leader during her career. This was overwritten during Halo Initiation, where she is depicted as a Lance Corporal, and yet the Halo 4 Visual Guide states that her leadership was a primary reason for her recruitment. Catalog clears this up in part, saying that she was on track for advanced promotion to Sergeant. Still, it seems wise to regard the Halo 4 Interactive Guide as mostly non-canon, since, in light of recent canon, Palmer's profile is wrong in many regards. Besides rank, it also states that she was in the Marines for over 10 years before her recruitment into the program. However, the Halo 4 Visual Guide says she was born in 2527, meaning that she wouldn't be able to join the Marines until 2544, and that's with early recruitment. Query, does the Covenant's native cruiser classification, Reverence, coincide with any of the UNSC's three-letter classifications? CRS, CCS, RCS, ORS.
Query, answer. Covenant naval classifications do not follow human standards.
Query, through what process did the fragmentation of the Meta-Arc class and Scylla Mendicant Bias end up on the key ship on the Sanshayum homeworld? Why was the key ship left on the planet at all if there were live forerunners to oversee the receding process?
Query, answer. No, conservation lifeboats were to be left on indexed planets. Human administrative records indicate archived, Covenant, records are currently being researched by human and, Marto Cognatus, librarian, teams at CE-80-9012-D.
So, we don't really know why the Forerunner key ship was left on Janjir Quom, or why a fragment of Mendicant Bias was on board, but it is being researched by human and Sangheili teams on Sanghelios. What's the status of Captain James Jim Gregory Cutter that was last seen on board Phoenix-class support vessel Spirit of Fire?
Query, answer. Human naval records have no updates on status after February 10th, 2534.
As expected, there are no records of the Spirit of Fire after its disappearance. The date given is when the ship was reclassified as Lost with All Hands. Now, just a few days ago, it seems I was able to coax a post from Catalog. I recently said on a topic that I would bet my Halo collection that the Didact was not going to appear in Halo Escalation 9, and that the cover was a reference to the confrontation aboard Mantle's approach in Halo 4. Catalog responded to my bet.
Note, Catalog has researched multiple human flea market agents who will surely be of use to you.
Needless to say, I quickly withdrew my bet. And over the course of making this script, more responses appeared. Query, how did the flood outbreak on Installation 05 occur without a source of appropriate biomass?
Query, answer. Unable to access vector of parasite infestation at Delta site without additional sensor data.
Damn! So close! Query, what is the status of Sergeant Zhao Hang Lopez following the infestation of the Mona Lisa?
Query, answer. Human naval records list 11283-99001-ZL Ref Sergeant Lopez as KIA October 25th, 2552. Alert! Suppressing spider response. Scope increase failed.
So this is an interesting one. It seems that we finally have a date for the events of the Mona Lisa, or at least when the UNSC Red Horse arrived. Also a service ID for Zhao Hang Lopez, so that's kind of cool. Query, what is the status of Nolan Byrne?
Query, answer. Human Security Forces List 48780-19114-NB, Ref. Sergeant Major Byrne, S. KIA, November 17th, 2552.
So if you haven't read Contact Harvest, Sergeant Nolan Byrne was another Spartan 1 and had a long history with Sergeant Avery Johnson. Along with a service number, it seems that he died on November 17th, 2552, probably during the invasion of Earth. Statement. In the collection of Forerunner data strings known as Silentium, the librarian stated that there were some Forerunner vessels, a fortress class, a handful of dreadnoughts, and a few scrap heap transports inside Requiem, Shield World 001.
Query, answer. Searching. Contacting domain. Failure. Regress. Can infer reallocation of combat effective assets located at Warrior Servant Castra Requiem to nearby facilities in accordance to Fleet Command directives.
Query. What happened to said vessels during the various engagements at Requiem during February 2558, which I will from now on designate as the Requiem Occupation Campaign?
Query. Answer. Human naval and frumentary records indicate Promethean Command warship, Ref. Mantle's approach, escorted by multiple Forerunner small craft. Analysis of shape language and optical characteristics. Identify these as C-330 utility vehicles. Expected complement of combat small craft and Harriers not noted. Analysis of multispectral and dynamic signal characteristics indicate Promethean Command warship lost primary structural integrity 2552 07 25 23 14 23 with heart conducting emergency. Slipstream space, transit to sector, rally point.
Now it seems that there were a number of combat-ready vessels on Requiem before the Halo Raid fired, but many were removed from the Shield World during the Forerunner Flood War. Some, Catalog seems to assume, remained, but others were curiously absent when the Didact left Requiem. The end of the second answer in this chain is talking about the destruction of Mantle's approach by a nuke. Catalog says 2552, but I'm pretty certain he means 2557. I know I'll type 2552 often enough when I mean 57 or 58. 2552 is just such an iconic year to Halo. Catalog also notes an emergency slipspace transit at the heart of the ship, referencing Cortana saving the chief when the nuke went off. Additional query, were the vessels salvaged by Covenant Splinter faction led by Julum Dama, hereafter referred to as the Storm Covenant, for ease of designation?
Query, answer. Human naval and frumentary records in accessible cores do not indicate Covenant control of Forerunner combat vessels.
Again, referencing the previously mentioned ships said to have been stored on Requiem. Query, what is the status of the Lifeworker Key ship once held by the Perfidia Vermis, designated Truth by the UNSC, original name Ord Casto?
Query, answer. Multiple record discrepancies noted in available frumentary cores. Corrupted compartmentalization links noted. Reconstructed logistical links and sensor logs recovered from human smallcraft, Ref, forward unto dawn. Indicate Lifeworker Conservation Lifeboat present on Waypoint as of December 11, 2552.
Interesting thing here is that Catalog refers to the Lesser Ark as Waypoint, which was, in fact, one of the proposed names for the Ark back during Halo 2's development. Query, what is the status of the Lifeworker Exploration Vessel designated Audacity?
Query, answer. Records in local cache report allocation to Pioneer Group upon return from long-range exploration mission. Contact Fleet Command for additional information.
For reference, the Audacity was the ship that the librarian and a small crew used to travel to Path Cathona. Query, has the UNSC outfitted ships with prototype ventral beams and other forms of point defense energy weapons as evidenced in ships of Covenant design?
Query, answer. Frumentary records indicate multiple research vector approaches in adapting Covenant fleet offensive technologies. Human materials exploration builders, Ref. Reap X, have recovered and retrofitted handful of Covenant vessels for threat dynamic and destructive testing analysis.
So nothing's been adapted yet, but tests are underway. High priority query. Why is the Arbiter Thelvadum listed as a target priority alpha by ONI?
Query, answer. Analysis of frumentary eyes. Protocol indicate all Macho Cognatus administrative and military authorities designated priority targets for acquisition of threat dynamic information related to plans and policies.
Basically, ONI is weary of the Sangheili. Makes sense after 27 years of war and the continued resistance from various Covenant factions, Julum Dama, Merg Vol, and who knows how many more. Query, what were the Spartan tags of Olivia and Mark from Gamma Company?
Query, answer. Human naval records list requested individuals as Olivia G-291 and Mark G-313.
Nice to know that. I love little details. Query, does Catalog have information as to the fate of Spartan 2 KHE-047? Last intelligence refers to engagement between Covenant forces in February 2531.
Query, answer. Human naval and frumentari records list Explorator KHE-047 as MIA.
So the Spartan KHE-047 was mentioned in some Halo Wars ancillary material and present on Harvest. Would be nice to know when he was listed as MIA, just so we have that. Query, in light of the information recently made available from them, Ref Glasslands, what are the surnames of Spartans Fred 104, Kelly 087, and Linda 058?
Query, answer. Elevated access to Frumentari Onion router required for data behind glass. Contact System Bravo for assistance and routing information.
Interesting. System Bravo has previously referenced the Halo Waypoint Twitter account. I wonder if they would actually release the surnames of these Spartans. Query, why did PFC Jenkins stay the same rank the whole war?
Query, answer. Analysis of human security forces, authority structure relationships defies cursory analysis.
Seems kind of like a joke post. Basically, humans are weird. Well, that's it for now. I'm sure that by the time I post this, though, there will be more Catalog posts, but that's another video. This has been Halo Canon. I'll see you next time, Spartans. Hey guys, thanks for watching my video. It means a lot. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and maybe share it around on whatever social media you choose. Your support is greatly appreciated. I cannot stress that enough. Thanks for watching.